Hey folks, Valentin the Mad here, and today we'll be looking at the destruction effects in the beta of Battlefield 2042. Mainly at what's there, some of the limitations, and whether it delivers a responsive feel. Let's get right into it. First up is the terrain deformation, and that is back big time. It's a feature we have since the Bad Company games, and it's really cool. It looks good, and the damage is permanent, so by the end of the round, you'll be seeing those everywhere. Also, if I'm not mistaken, in the previous games, the terrain damage was pretty limited in some of the built areas. So if you had a bunch of buildings or warehouses, the response you would see would be either a decal or a reveal of some overlay, but there was no terrain deformation, as far as I recall. As you can see here, the deformation is going right up to the building, structure, or indestructible prop. You still do have some areas where damage is limited to revealing only an overlay or even a decal that will disappear, but those are far fewer than at least I remember from previous games. Rocks, however, still can't get damaged. And more on the nature side of things, vegetation annihilation is also back in all its glory. Trees can be destroyed and, if I'm not mistaken, every single tree. Even the larger ones, the kind that would survive in previous games, they can be brought down. And of course, bushes can also be blown up and any grass will disappear around craters. So I think the vegetation damage in Aftermath are just awesome. Now as for destructible buildings, I only noticed several of those. You can shoot them up from different sides, destroy walls and sections, but not completely bring them down. And some sections are unresponsive. So I haven't seen any building you can completely bring down in this map. And I should note that you can't damage this large building in any notable way. There are a bunch of props you can damage and destroy on it, but that's about it. The response there is very limited. I don't want to talk about the industrial areas in the map. You can damage a lot there, but generally not really demolish much. So, this large structure, for example, haven't seen it take any notable damage. You can damage the pipes, you can destroy the railings, but that's about it. The bridges and walkways still. You can destroy the railings, but I haven't noticed any major damage there. Most containers also get a heavily damaged, but not really a destroyed state. Most, not all. But still, compared to what I remember from the previous games and notably BF3 and 4, this is absolutely more responsive. Of course, should be noted, there are a ton of destructible or damageable props scattered all across the map. But you do have a fair bit of unresponsive ones too. Large containers are basically the nemesis of destruction in Battlefield series. And I also noticed that there's a lot more debris on vehicle explosions. Generic debris, not something particularly specific, and it disappears quickly too, but still, kinda cool. And the cherry on top is the Levolution rocket explosion event. When the fueling arms come down and the rocket prepares for takeoff, you can damage it, and if a certain threshold is reached before it takes off, you will see a pretty glorious explosion, sending massive debris flying all over the place and transforming that section of the map. It is a scripted event and it will be the same every time, doesn't deliver some amazingly responsive feel, but it is a nice feature, as I mentioned, a sort of a cherry on top. In the bottom line, the main thing that delivers that dynamic war-torn feel is the craters. The vast majority of the terrain can be deformed and, by the mid-end of a fight, it will be just a glorious mess. However, when it comes to other aspects, like in the previous games, it is pretty limited. There are a whole bunch of destructible props, a lot of stuff you can damage, some walls you can chew up and bring down, but you can't really demolish the built areas and the industrial zones where you have the objectives and most of the action. So, if you like the Battlefield series, the gameplay, you'll definitely appreciate all the damage you can cause, but if destruction and responsive environments are the main draw for you, at least based on this beta, it is not a game that I can recommend. I will, however, be covering the full game too and we'll see what else it will have. It is entirely possible that other maps would deliver more of a responsive feel. So I hope you enjoyed this video, do let me know what you think in the comments below, and subscribe for more sponsor-related content coming your way soon. Until next time!